Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we will be talking about how you can improve your PCOS symptoms naturally in just 5 easy steps. So as I mentioned, today we will be talking about 5 ways you can improve your PCOS symptoms. I would like to preface that this is not a medical advice. So if you struggle with any of your PCOS symptoms, please make sure you seek medical advice. First thing we're going to be talking about is elimination. So we're going to have to eliminate few things from your life. Think about your body as a computer. Now, if you have a computer virus, your processor is not going to work as effectively, is it? So first thing we're going to have to do is take out all the things that may harm you. First thing that we're going to have to eliminate are cigarettes. Cigarettes are also proven by science to decrease your fertility. So this is going to be the first thing that has to go. Believe me, I understand that this is a very difficult thing to quit cigarettes. I've been a smoker myself, but this is the first thing that you're going to have to do. Second thing is alcohol. As we all know, alcohol is classified as a poison. So alcohol has to be actually digested by our liver, and liver also takes care of a lot of our hormones as well. So if we want to make sure that everything is working properly, it would be better to eliminate or at least limit the poison to minimum. What is more, alcohol is very inflammatory. So if you have any sort of inflammatory processes happening in your body, it's just going to make them worse. Next thing is processed food and junk food. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about the diet in one of the next points, but junk food generally is also compacted with a lot of bad ingredients, with a lot of preservatives, chemicals, with a lot of fake hormones that are being put in the meat and so on. So the best thing to do would be drop junk food. Now, when we already eliminated all the stuff that harm us, we should actually adjust our lifestyle. And this is the thing that many people skip because we either cannot do it or it's a very difficult thing to do, or we just don't appreciate how important it is. So first thing you're gonna have to do is sleep. If it's for weight loss, if it's for detoxification, for any sort of recuperation of your body, sleep is absolutely crucial. So try to shoot in between 7 and even 9 of hours of sleep, especially if you know that you have any sort of health problems. Giving your body time to actually relax and recover is very, very important. Another thing is exercise. Many of us with PCOS have problem with insulin resistance, whether it is visible in the labs or whether it is on a cellular level. We very often struggle with that. So exercise is improving your insulin sensitivity and then production of androgens that in turn into all the horrible side effects of PCOS. Another thing is to de-stress. Try to avoid the situations and people that stress you out. And we are going to be talking about mental hygiene in a minute as well. Next thing is adjusting the diet. And I'm pretty sure that most of you with PCOS have heard about it. Many women with PCOS struggle with acne, with insulin resistance, with obesity and so on. So adjusting your diet is absolutely crucial for both your mental health and your physical health. Many gynecologists already recommend going quite low carb. So what I would recommend for you is to try with the low carb diet. Now you have few options. If you're just starting and you find it very difficult to have even a little bit breaks between your meals, you're getting hungry, you binge eat, which I've been through. If you have difficulty not eating, start with intermittent fasting. I will have a video about intermittent fasting separately and how it improves insulin resistance. Next step will probably be low carb, and the ultimate step will be ketogenic diet, when we limit our carbohydrates intake to 20 grams. All of those diets help you get more insulin sensitive, which in turn creates less of androgens in your body and less facial hair, less body hair, less acne, and so on and so forth. And of course, less cysts on your ovaries. Another thing that is very often skipped is practicing your mind hygiene. It is very rarely talked about, but women with PCOS are proven to have much bigger issues with anxiety and depression. So practicing mind hygiene for us is extremely important. And what I would recommend for that? I would recommend meditation. Now, for all of you who are very down to earth, and when you hear of meditation, you think about some crazy mumbo jumbo. Meditation is basically trying to ground yourself and being in the present moment. I definitely recommend the app Headspace, which I'm gonna link down below. There are plenty of apps for meditation, so you can choose whatever you prefer. You can also meditate in different ways. Maybe if you're religious, you can pray. Maybe you just want to go out in the nature and just trying to get away from all phones, people, everything, and just meditate this way. Maybe, I don't know, doing makeup, maybe knitting gives you a little bit peace of the mind. But please try and practice meditation or this little moment for yourself. Another very important thing for us to practice mind hygiene is finding community. There is many groups on Facebook. There are people on Twitter, Instagram, everywhere that are actually talking about PCOS. And you can find people that are struggling with very similar symptoms to you. Finding a group of people, even online, that you can talk to and who are going through similar things really help not to feel alone. And the last thing, if you really struggle with horrible anxiety or depression, don't be afraid to ask for professional help. Find the therapies that you like and stick to them. It's 21st century. Most of us have been in therapy at some point in our lives. And the last point, which probably a lot of you have heard about, but I will stress, no amount of adding certain stuff is gonna do anything if you are extremely stressed, if you smoke, drink, don't relax, if you maybe have a horrible diet. If you're gonna add supplements in those circumstances, they are not gonna help. It's very important to do those steps almost in order and then focus on whatever you can add. Of course, you can add those things before, but they're not going to work as well if you're not going to take care of first four points. So the last point is adding. What many of your doctors already will recommend for you if you have PCOS is inositol. It's very important to take two types of inositol, and it's myo-inositol and dichiro-inositol, and in a correct ratio. So it should be 40:1 myo-inositol to dichiro-inositol. I'm gonna link down below the supplement that I have found that actually is really good ratio, or you can buy two separate ones and just take myo-inositol and dichiro-inositol separately. What inositol does, myo-inositol is actually proven to improve not only PCOS symptoms, but also your insulin sensitivity and your insulin resistance, and also improve fertility. So if you are someone who is thinking about actually having kids, or you just want to relieve your symptoms a little bit, taking inositol is proven to work, but it has to be the right type. So second thing that is talked about quite extensively is Vitex. Vitex is actually a herb, and Vitex actually influences your progesterone levels. So for some people, it can be a miracle pill. For some people, it can do more harm than good. So because Vitex is quite powerful medication, I would always contact your medical professional to get an advice whether you should take Vitex or not. Because if your progesterone levels are okay, taking Vitex can do more harm than good. So another thing that you can add is all sorts of herbs and spices that are gonna help you with your symptoms. So for example, it can be sweet mint that is improving your androgen levels in your body. So you just drink a little bit of a sweet mint tea every day. Another thing is cinnamon that is improving our insulin sensitivity, apple cider vinegar that is doing exactly the same thing. And there are actually many like those that can improve your health. So that's it for that video. These were five very basic things that you can start doing to improve your PCOS symptoms naturally. One thing that I want to stress, you don't have to do everything perfect at the beginning, and you won't do everything perfect at the beginning. Take one step at a time. Myself, it took me 3 years to have no problem with binge eating and to start seeing improvements in my health by doing it step by step, by quitting cigarettes, by quitting alcohol, by improving my diet, exercise, and so on. So remember, this is a marathon, not a sprint. Just take one step for yourself today. Now, I will link all the products that I mentioned in the description down below. Follow me on Instagram, on Twitter, and here on YouTube for more videos like that. Let's stay healthy. Let's beat this PCOS. See you in the next video. Bye.